next.
Falstaff Brewery.
You got audio on that?
Yeah.
Let's go to the question mark for our break.
Should we tour the bottle shop?
Yeah.
Should we?
Yeah, get it all.
How about the parking lot? Thousands of unfilled cans awaiting our needy customers.
The warehouse. It used to be the American Can Building.
A lot of action over here. More action at D.O. McCombs.
Dave, what's his name?
Oh, is it Ryder?
Yeah.
We get out of here with that camera.
All right, here we have one of our
industrious foremen here.
Coming over here to check out any pilferage.
I wouldn't let anybody catch you guys up here with cameras.
Really?
Mm-mm.
We have to get a picture of Cool Will.
What's going on?
What the hell is he doing?
What's
up? You want to
this is illegal activity. Right. Japanese are...
Oh, I look with my glasses on. Do I look like a professor? Suppose I could get a job somewhere as a professor.
No yeah. Comment, huh?
Hey, you guys, you got brew tomorrow now, huh?
Six more brews.
Six more.
Is that what it then?
Yeah.
Why, what happened with the city? Why did you get six more? I don't
think you
had enough. Did
they quit boarding the way?
Yeah, I heard that. I don't know.
Is Cub Foods hiring?
I think so.
Got it. Hey.
Another one of the industrialists.
Yeah,
equal opportunity, power, Falstaff.
Smile, you're on candid camera, motherfucker.
What is this, a compactor?
Yeah.
Fact. has some more control area. Syrup area. Water tub. Appreciate a little better. Story.
upstairs into the rack area.
Should have come up here when they were racking. second, I gotta... upstairs to the wort cooler?
Bee cellar.
up the stairway in search of the master carbonator, Floyd Cook. Hopefully we will find him diligently at work. Yes, I've spotted him.
Just a little demonstration.
What?
A little demonstration.
Yeah.
Huh? Not ready yet?
Yeah.
Woo! Yes. Woo! Probably pretty cold, isn't it? About 33?
Not sure. Yeah.
What's that, about 34?
Thank you.
nobody working. It's either you or Clyde. Big choice.
Come on.
Grable. Thank you.
dumping his pre-coat for a primary filter.
Shots of the bolted up kettles here. Panel board where they stole the flax. Bolted up handles. Kettles. Not in use for many years. Get them before they bring the trucks in.
They ain't gonna bring no trucks in.
Won't they?
Why should they? All the rest of the plants have all this equipment.
I'll let the brothers steal it, huh?
Yep, it's all gone.
There'll be some rest little nigger boys running around this neighborhood.
Don't think you're gonna take these mills out, Lays?
I doubt it. They've got three good lays here that mill just like me. But hell, Bert said we were ribbon up there at Milwaukee had all new machines. They didn't know we got all the order. Don't need anything. No taxes, got all the best.
Seven or 28.
this tank either.
Yeah, let me close this down here.
Been on it, it's probably all right. Came across the other one, you know, when you're filming Little up there. I don't know how you did that. I've been trying to do it.
I didn't bump the wrong button.
I don't know which one you hit and did it. Do it.
I don't know.
I've never
seen him do that before. Talk about weird, I'm sitting here, you know, here's one scene wiping out another one. It's kind of neat. What they do, have some leftover grains and stuff, is that why they brew it?
I guess, I don't know. They still got some left over.
Yeah. I think my battery for my clock is starting to wear out. It's about 10 minutes behind. It's been about a year now. I'm gonna have to change it. Probably about 2 years, like a watch, huh? Year to 2 years. You got one in yours? For clock and date? First time I put it in, I had the wrong year. We had 87 in there instead of 88. Didn't notice it until I started filming, you know, or looking at the film. Whoops, wrong year.
The light tips out every so often. I don't know why. Maybe the battery's getting weak.
Probably.
But when you go to reset it, it'll come back on. I think mine starts at 86 or something.
I went up to water cooler the other day, and you know, back in the cooling room, it's so hot in there, the lens started fogging up. It took me about 15 minutes to get the moisture off of it. Then when I finally did that, it kept shutting down because says, you know, at 105 degrees, the battery will kick out. So I could go in there for about a minute and then it'd shut off. And I'd have to go back out the room or wherever it was. Then I'd go back in and film for about a minute or two. But, you know, it's about, what, 140 in there or something? That's the first time I've ever had any trouble with the camera. It just turns itself off automatically. Just sit there and kick right off.
act like I'm dumping a hop.
Okay. We wouldn't want to overload it.
You need that help? I gotta turn it on. Here it comes.
You gonna spray out?
A little bit, maybe, but ain't gonna be enough. How's that? Don't, down here is coming out now. Got her? That's how you get the rest of the wort off the top of the grain.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Then it goes through the grain and it's just like a coffee deal, you know what I mean? You siphon
over
it through. It. Yeah.
How deep is it?
That's 18 inches deep. A grain.
Well, that ain't that bad, isn't it? Looks like it'd be about 3 feet.
No, it's 18 inches.
Like I'm armed to move faster than that.
Well, they will when I start pumping it. And you can...
like shoulders Friday. Couldn't even see them in the viewfinder. Lenny wants to show this to his kids. None of them believe he works for a living.
Got a good break, which it does.
Yeah.
And the clearness, if you can see, I don't know if you can see the clearness, but if you get a shine to it, that means it's good.
Huh. How often do you check that?
Huh?
How often do you check that?
Well, we check it after every time we get it pulled, just to make sure that you got the right, you know, that it's boiling good and hard. They want you to roll it, you know. The harder, the better the roll, the better the oil you got.
Don't look in the lens and break it.
Yeah.
He says, Mickey's gonna watch this. And these guys said, yeah, so he dropped his thing. He's on the camera.
Not yet. see that on instant replay.
Oh, yeah, it's supposed to be here a few minutes earlier, man.
You got that carbonated good, huh?
Thank you. Workers at the Falstaff Brewery were told this morning that 2 months from today, they'll be out of a job.
The workers are blaming management, while management blames lagging beer sales.
The cold gray day matched the mood here at the Fort Wayne Falstaff Brewery to a T. This morning, these workers were told that after the first of the year, they'd be out of a job. They were all upset and blamed the closing on several management changes. Management blamed slow beer sales.
We met with all Falstaff employees today to make them aware of this, the closing, and to begin preparation for a timely and orderly shutdown.
There are only 125 workers left here at the Falstaff Brewery. None of them wish to be interviewed on camera. However, off camera, they did say that today's news did come as a shock, but once they got to think about it, they realized that the closing was inevitable.
Sherman Sims has lived next door to the Falstaff Brewery for 33 years.
There wasn't too many trailers. Oh, in the last 2 or 3 months, they wasn't really that busy. As far as I can see now, I don't know what's going on inside the plant.
Steve Murphy runs a service station across the street.
There's been rumors for 5 to 10 years about it closing. It's changed ownership, what, I'm sure you know more than me, 3, 4 times in the past 10 years. There's been a lot of rumors about it, yes. But when it hits, it's still a shock.
January 7th is the announced closing date. It's a tough pill for many workers to swallow. Many have been with the company for decades. As for the future of the brewery, there is only speculation. But right now, the well is running dry.
Some members of the Falstaff sales team and a few maintenance workers will remain on the job past the closing date.
The brewery business has been an important part of the history of this city. With its German heritage, beer was the drink of choice.
For over a century, breweries played an important role in Fort Wayne's way of life. The old Scentliver Brewery on Spy Run sponsored major circuses, boat rides, and horse races. It even had its own trolley for people to ride out and buy beer at the brewery. The Berghoff Brewery, which later became Falstaff, was begun in 1887 and was one of the largest breweries in the Midwest. Berghoff sold to Falstaff in 1954. In the 1800s, beer wagons were a familiar sight around Fort Wayne.
It's not uncommon to hear stories about brewery wagons. The horses just simply knew where to go. Every saloon down Main Street or Berry Street, the horses just walked on their own and stopped until the load was unloaded, and then would walk on to the next saloon and stop, and all you needed to do was unload the horses. Very fond memories of all of that. And very typical of Midwestern towns like Fort Wayne.
With the closing of Falstaff Brewery, Fort Wayne is losing something that made it special once upon a time.
Well, a great tradition has passed, the only thing that can be said. People have lost their jobs and another part of the economy has gone away, but even more than that, there's something, this is a pun, something spiritual, something spirited about the brewery life in this community that was every bit a part of the way in which people enjoyed things in this community. It was kind of always looked upon with a certain fondness, the brewery down the street or across town, providing
Milwaukee will continue to make.
You got audio on
it. And it could not have happened at a worse time. The 35-year-old brewery is closing its doors in 60 days. 200 workers will spend the upcoming holidays not toasting their hometown beer, but looking for new jobs.
Well, guys are, unhappy. What can you say? A lot of guys have been here over 30 years.
What do you do now?
Start putting out resumes. That's all I can do. I gotta find a job.
The company says the plant is closing because of declining sales. Falstaff finished 1988 as the 8th largest brewery in the country, but its share of the U.S. beer market was less than 1%. The Washington-based Beer Institute says Falstaff brewed 1.6 million barrels of beer under 3 brand names last year. At one time, the beer maker operated plants in 6 other states. The Fort Wayne location, its last.
It's always been a lot of people's minds around here because we're the last Falstaff plant in existence. And we have been the last one for quite a few years. And now it's over.
Chris Bradley, 21 Alive.
The plant closing shocked some of the workers, but because sales have been falling and losses mounting for nearly a decade, Many people on the payroll say they knew a shutdown was inevitable.
And ever since I've been here, they've been talking about closing the plant down, so it was probably going to come anyway, sooner or later.
But others were bitter about the decision.
You know, they're a large corporation. They're entitled to do what they have to do to survive. And they really don't care about the little guy like us, I guess, if they're going to cut us out here.
The closing of this beer plant is bad news for the people who work here and for the people who drink Falstaff beer. Right now, this is the only Falstaff brewery in the nation. There's a chance that Falstaff production could now be shifted to a Pabst brewery in Milwaukee or another plant in the state of Washington. But company officials say there's no decision on that yet. In recent months, Falstaff has laid off dozens of workers here. Only about 125 employees were scheduled to show up on the job this day. The company is still trying to figure out how to phase out the remaining employees before the closing date of January 7th.
We simply have to finish production and start a closeout schedule, and all that has to be determined as we look into the plant and see what the needs are.
The announcement comes just 2 weeks before Thanksgiving and 6 weeks before Christmas.
Ed, have you ever wondered what an airplane went through to get pieces of the old Falstaff Brewery overseas? Being taken piece by piece to China, and right now crews are moving some major parts. 36 finishing tanks are being taken one by one. These tanks hold 600 barrels of beer each. Once each tank is taken out, it's loaded on a flatbed truck, one at a time, and driven to Burns Harbor and then shipped to China. These tanks will be part of what will be China's largest brewery.
That's the latest from your 24-hour local news channel.
Stay with TV 33 for hourly news and outdoor weather updates, and join Laura Emerson and David Morin at 9 tomorrow morning for your next in-depth newscast.
We leave you at the brewery. We'll see you tomorrow at 6.
Any glass in my tongue?
Hey, did you eat yet? Did you eat hot dogs?
No, I'm all up with business.
Well, that's an ass this morning to get blood.
Good morning. Noriega thinks he's got a date somewhere.
Looking well, you.
Jolly safe, Nick.
Are you? Don't let the thing fool you. That's me.
No, it is.
You best have some business.
Where the rest of the construction crew are.
Hey, no sense of beating around the bush.
You gonna let the other guys eat, Jay?
No. I figure I better wait until you guys are here.
There's some venison there.
Some
real horse meat, right, Lenny?
You know I am.
Prime stuff.
Barnett will be pissed if he comes up and it's gone again.
He didn't show up today.
Didn't he?
That's too cold for him.
The bandolero will show his face.
I think I better eat last. Leave somebody
else. I say, Spear Case or Limburger. Yeah. Oh, I'll get your head out of here.
Oh, this has candy.
All right, candy ass.
What you might like.
I'm thinking candy. You're going to get out there with Petrie. That's right. What you're saying. We're going to get out there. Petrie's there.
Hey, you guys are all right.
You
know, it took Clyde to tell me you had
turkey. Did it?
Yeah, I didn't smell it. He told me.
That's all you do about it.
I didn't know you guys were going
to. Yeah, he'd seen you in a while. Saw Skip yesterday.
Yeah, they keep me so busy around here, I don't have a chance to socialize too much.
Yeah.
Really bad?
Mail clerk. We could go Thursday, he left. $5.50 an hour.
Oh.
He moved himself.
Oh. Happy Hanukkah!